Hello and welcome to the latest ACS travel restrictions news. This week coming to you from Bournemouth's XLR Jet Centre. Located in the south of England, it offers a remote and secure location with minimal touch points as you pass through the facility. The airport itself is ideally located next to the UNESCO World Heritage Site of the Jurassic Coast and is very convenient for the world-famous sandbanks, often dubbed Britain's Palm Beach. The big news this week is the strong rumours coming out of the UK that they're setting up air bridges with popular summer destinations like France, Spain, Greece and Italy. If you're looking to capitalise on these new developments, we strongly advise you to contact one of our account managers to register your interest. We do expect a high demand for charters as these bridges are officially announced within the next few weeks. The Scandinavian bubble is now extended to include Norway, Denmark, Iceland, Finland and Sweden. This is expected to stay in place until the 31st of August. As a general overview of the rest of Europe, most Schengen countries are now allowing limited access to each other, though some do require COVID-19 checks and some have no restrictions at all. A full list of the current restrictions are available on the Travel Restrictions website. In Asia this week, another travel bubble is being discussed, this time between Malaysia and Indonesia. Both countries are highly dependent on each other for tourism, so this is seen as an essential bubble as we move into the post-lockdown era. Myanmar has announced they will open their borders from the 1st of July. However, as their monsoon season has just started and runs until October, after that, the ancient city and UNESCO World Heritage Site of Old Bagan is definitely worth a visit. Here, the remains of close to 4,000 temples and pagodas still survive to the present day. This is also the best time to take in a hot air balloon ride over the temples with the long-established Balloons of Bagan company. In the Middle East, Dubai has reopened for residents only, with tourists allowed in from the 7th of July, albeit with strict rules of entry. Arrivals will be required to produce a medical certificate showing a negative COVID-19 test result within the past 4 days, or have the test carried out on arrival. Anyone testing positive will be isolated in an institutional facility provided by the government for 14 days at their own expense. This does not apply to other Emirates in the UAE as they remain in lockdown. Egypt will be opening their tourist destinations from the 1st of July, allowing travellers into parts of the country less hard hit by COVID-19. These include the Sinai Peninsula, home to the diving havens of Sharm el-Sheikh, Hurghada and the Red Sea. Saudi Arabia has now dropped their national curfew ahead of the annual pilgrimage. However, they are limiting pilgrimages to those of Saudi residents only at this stage. As India struggles to open its borders, they have started looking at travel bubbles with essential countries. We have to wait to find out which countries they will be, however, and whether it will even be practical to do so, given that India is still struggling to get its COVID-19 outbreaks under control. In the Indian Ocean, the Maldives will fully open from the 15th of July to all tourists without any quarantine restrictions. However, you will still require a health declaration on arrival. The Seychelles are open. However, as previously mentioned, access is limited to private jets only. We do expect this restriction to be lifted on or around the 15th of July. Across in the Caribbean, we're seeing more locations opening, with Bermuda and the Bahamas due to open on the 1st of July. There are also strong rumours that Barbados will do so very soon. In Australasia, the so-called Tasman bubble is reported to be in jeopardy, as new cases of COVID-19 have been reported in the Australian state of Victoria this week. In North America, the US domestic market is still very strong. Previously, the popular southern and western states have seen the most tourist activity. However, as these states are now seeing spikes in coronavirus cases, the Northeast has imposed domestic quarantine procedures, and we now expect the travel trend to become focused on more remote locations such as Montana and Utah, or the national parks like Yosemite and Yellowstone in the north. Finally, this week's recommended isolation getaway is Mauritius, a volcanic island in the southern Indian Ocean. From mid-June, the humidity reduces and the temperatures are a pleasant 22 degrees. They have also announced this week they're COVID-free. If you are travelling this week, stay safe. If not, please do check back with the Travel Restrictions website for further updates.